Greetings, travelers. It is I, SundaeOfDoom, here to wreak havoc upon all that are uninformed. This is an announcement video that the PAX East Freeflight is going on right now. CIG won't actually be at PAX East this year, but they decided to keep it a tradition to have the Freeflight demo available for anyone who registers to their website. There's also going to be a military ship sale going on, but I'll talk about that a little bit later on in the video. So today is Friday, April 15th, 2016, and this free flight will be going all the way until Monday, April 25th, 2016. So you got quite a bit of time to actually try out Star Citizen and see if it works on your system and if it tickles your fancy. What does this mean actually mean for those who haven't pledged for Star Citizen yet? Well, you get access to three ships, the Aurora LN, which is the more combat variant of the Aurora series. You get two extra size 1 weapon mounts at the top and a larger generator in the back. What that means is it provides more power for your energy-based weaponry. You also get the F7C Hornet, which is the baseline Hornet in the Hornet series. It doesn't come with the ball turret like the Super Hornet does, but it is pretty formidable on its own. Then you have the Mustang Delta, which is the combat variant of the Mustang series, and it is quite a fun ship to fly around with. It's faster than the Aurora and more nimble. A little bit more flimsy, but it has dumbfire missiles on this sucker. So that means that if you can get up close to someone and just keep launching those dumbfire missiles, you'll be making a pretty large dent in their shields and armor. What you also get is the access to the mini PU, or the baby PU as I like to call it, which is a one system in the one system out of the, like, I think 115 or 116 systems that Star Citizen will have. That might seem small, but if you think about it, someone actually flew from one end, and this was of the first iteration of the Crusader, flew from one end of the system to the other, and it took them 19.5 hours to do it in cruise mode, which is like, I think it's like nine. I don't know what the top speed is, but it's like a really fast meters per second speed, like in the 600s plus kind of range. So it's quite large, and unlike other kind of games where it's going to be, or it's more about procedural generation and having like trillions and trillions of systems to go into, this one is going to be more handcrafted. They're still going to be having procedural generation a part of the game, but it's more of a kind of focused in their control kind of procedural generation that they're going to be doing, and they look it over and make sure that everything looks right and actually fits the setting. So it's quite fun so far with it. It's still limited, but I think you'll have fun flying around with it, and you also get to test out the multi-crew features where you can actually have your buddies come with you and, you know, man the shields and stuff like that, and energy, and figure out what would be like what you need to, like, which shield side do you need the more energy at, and should I put more energy into the weapons or the shields or the engines, that kind of fun stuff. You also get access to the Arena Commander, which is the simulation in the simulation. It's basically when the Persistent Universe comes out, like, meaning when the MMO portion of Star Citizen goes live, you will have access to you'll have an issue where if you die, you only have a certain amount of times when you could come back to life. Like, your body can only sustain a certain amount of surgeries before it gives out to, and you basically have to, it's like, it's permadeath. Your character dies, but your next aligned inherits all the stuff that you have, except for a good chunk of your credits or your money and a good chunk of your reputation. So it'd be like you're the family of this dreaded pirate Roberts, so you still get a reputation that you're in the family of pretty nefarious people, but it's not as well known. A lot of you might go, oh well, what does it matter about reputation? Isn't it good that you have low reputation? Well, in this game, sometimes you want to have a higher reputation in something to actually try to get access to things, like, or get the trust of certain factions. So you might want to straddle the fence of being kind of like obscure if you're the kind of person that wants to play in a more gray area, kind of keep away from the law, but also keep away from being like a goody two-shoes. You might want to be like a ghost, basically. then you're going to be wanting to balance that out. But if you want something like more access to, maybe more military hardware or get like help from a local faction of pirates, then you might want to get a different, like, might build up your reputation as being a big bad pirate, or maybe being a pretty skillful bounty hunter. So what happens is, when you die, you die. And what Arena Commander is the way that is like the test bed for you to actually try out. Well, it's a test bed for Star Citizen. It's the first iteration of it. And, well, yeah. And it also gives you access to, like, just play, being able to play without having to worry about your character or your ship being destroyed. Also, your ship will get destroyed, and it will take time to be shipped to you, like a new version of it. Like, it's like if you busted your car and you still have insurance on it, they can send you a new car and stuff like that. Though the insurance is supposed to be very, really cheap and easy to maintain, so it shouldn't be too much of a worry, even if you're worried, like, if you're worried that if I buy a ship now or buy a package and get a ship, will I lose that ship later? I think in the long run, unless you want to roleplay as a person who's really bad at keeping their money and, like, doesn't, and always has like almost zero credits in their account, then you're very likely to have enough money to cover your hull insurance. So Arena Commander is your place to practice your FPS and your boarding and your actual flight techniques, so you don't have to worry about losing your life or having to deal with, you know, long trips back to wherever you're fighting before. It's like, because this is the one where you have the instant respawn, and you don't have to worry about any deaths and stuff like that. Then you also get the social module, which is it's basically just a kind of like a shop. It's a city. It's a small city plaza area where you get to see the first iteration of what cities are going to look like, or at least what, in this case, ArcCorp is a more industrial city. It's like, it's a city that is built up around mining and building things and fabrication. So it's not really a place that people want to be living there all their life, but it's a place where people live while they're working at ArcCorp. So you get to go into shops and see the, like, prices of guns that they have so far, and just walk around and see all the cool sights that you can see in ArcCorp. It's pretty cool. Not my taste, because I get bored of it after a couple of times, but I think you'll enjoy your first time and exploring what's around in the social module in ArcCorp. So you get access to those three parts of Star Citizen, and there's no other. That's basically what it is at this time in development, at least what they've given to us to be more available. What I should say is, it's more along the lines of, it's what's available for us right now, and not what they haven't shared with us yet, because they probably have a lot of stuff that they've been in development, but it's not ready to be shown or to be tested by the public. So it's quite awesome. You get to have a lot of fun with that. I have fun with it when I play with it, especially with friends. So if you can get some friends together and you want to try out Star Citizen, I suggest going to do this free flight. The military sale, which is down all the way here, isn't really much of a sale. It's not really that they don't lower the price or anything. It's just what I mean is, the Gladiator, I believe, is always available. The Gladius is always available, and the Retaliator Bomber is always available. What's actual limited, and what's not always available, is the F7C Super Hornet, which is the one that has the bold turret, that has more armor on it. It's supposed to be closer to in line with the actual military version of the Hornet. So, yeah, if you've been holding out to get one of these, you might want to go for it. So, yeah, you got some pretty fun stuff to deal with. If you haven't actually registered with Star Citizen yet, I'll show you how to actually register. You go to, once you get into Star Citizen, you go to My RSI, click that, you go to Enlist Now, which is just a fancy way of saying register, and then you put in your login, your handle, your community moniker, password, email, confirmation email, birthday. What I suggest you do is, if you have a friend that has Star Citizen, maybe put, or what you should do is you should put their referral code, ask them for the referral code and put it in here, and you basically get $5 or 5,000 UEC worth of in-game credits that you can spend on Voyager Direct now, though I suggest not spending it now and spending it later on when the actual MMO comes out. Like, basically save it up for later on. If you don't have a friend that plays Star Citizen, then you can always use my referral code. It does help me out a bit. It basically gives me like a recruitment point, and after a certain amount of recruits, I get like little gifts. Like right now, I'm 3 away from getting an actual that Gladius ship back there for free. Though it doesn't have any value to. I think I can play it in the Persistent Universe. I'm not entirely sure, but it doesn't have any value, so I can't. Like, I don't really like the Gladius that much, but but in this game, what you can, or right now, what you can do is you can actually exchange for credits to exchange stuff that you had bought before and melt it into and put it into another package so that you can get a better package with that. You can't actually do that with the Gladius, so yeah. What I'd be getting also is a golden statue of like a couple of ships, so yeah, it helps me out a bit. It's quite nice, and I appreciate it when people do that. And I would, if you don't have anyone that has a referral code, like any of your friends that have a referral code, you can use mine, and I appreciate that. But it's more for your benefit, because once you sign up, you get 5,000 UEC for free to play around with later on. Or if you want to get, say, a gun right now, I suggest not touching it now and just holding it off until later on. So yeah. But another thing I'd like to mention is, for your login ID, make sure it's totally different from your handle and community moniker. This is permanent, this login ID, and it should be something like, you can even put like number sign and like numbers in there, or like at signs and like stuff, just to throw off anyone who wants to hack into your account. The handle is your permanent call sign, so it's basically the thing that won't change. So you should also think on what's the more appropriate about this, like that you should actually use something that doesn't something that you're fine with being permanent. And the community moniker is the one that you can change. So if you have any org tags or clan tags, you can always put that in there, and it can be changed at any time. So yeah, I hope that was informative enough, and that you get a chance to try out the free flight and enjoy it, and hope to see you in there later days.